Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Making Investments Simple, and today I would be talking about market capitalization. To simplify this term, and you would have heard this term a lot of times about large cap, mid cap, small cap, and basically this capitalization, this is large cap actually means large market capitalization, mid cap means mid market capitalization, and small cap means small market capitalization. So market cap is a market value at a point of time of the shares outstanding of a publicly traded company, so being equal to the share price at that particular point of time. So there is a particular calculation, but as outstanding stock is bought and sold in public market, capitalization could be used as an indicator of public opinion of a company's net worth and is a determining factor in some forms of stock valuation. So what it is done is, even mutual funds have different categories about large cap. It actually means large market capitalization. So it is used by the investment community in ranking the size of companies as opposed to the sales or total asset figure. So large cap mutual fund actually means that they would have invested in companies which has large and huge market capitalization. For example, TCS and Infosys are large capitalizations in IT sector. In IT field, these two companies and some of these companies are having large market capitalization. It's a huge market capitalization, and their share price is also trading at a huge price. And same goes with some other sectors, like in banking sector, it is SBI, State Bank of India. It has a huge market capitalization in banking sector. So this is used as an investment community, and basically it ranks the companies as per its size. So the total capitalization of stock markets or economic regions may be compared with other economic indicators too. So there comes a calculation here. Market cap is equal to N into P. N is the number of shares outstanding and P is the closing price per share. So this keeps on changing. As you can see, the closing price of a share into the number of outstanding shares or publicly traded shares, that is market capitalization. And you can actually see this information in Money Control or any other website like Economic Times and other things, where the market capitalization is also shown. So for example, if some company has 4 million shares outstanding and the closing price per share is $20, its market cap it is then $80 million. If the closing price per share rises to $21, then the market cap becomes $84 million. So that's how, if it comes down and then again it falls down. So this is how the market cap keeps on increasing. Even so, if you see a lot of changes in the price of a share, the market capitalization also changes. Please keep that in mind. So hope you enjoyed this basic information video about market capitalization, and now you would have a better understanding about market cap, small cap, mid cap, large cap. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask me on my Facebook page or comments below on this videos. I'll be happy to look forward and answer them. And if you have any feedback on my videos, I'll be happy to answer them. I'll be happy to take them and create more quality and simple videos for you. Thank you, and I will see you again on my next video.